Good morning, children. In the last class, we learnt the atomic model made by Bohr at the energy levels. Today, let us learn atomic mass, atomic number, and mass numbers. What is atomic mass? Mass of any element. For example, mass of carbon is equal to 12. It says that the atomic mass of carbon. And what is atomic number? Atomic number of an element is the number of protons in the nucleus of its atom. Any atom you take, number of protons which present in the nucleus tells the atomic number. Thus, atomic number is a number of protons. So, this is atomic mass. Atomic number is number of protons is equal to number of protons which is present in the nucleus of an atom. Number of protons. Atomic number is equal to number of protons present in the nucleus. So atomic number is equal to number of protons. This atomic number is represented with the capital letter Z. So, it is denoted, atomic number is denoted with the capital letter Z. So, when you say any atomic number, not only it says the number of protons, we know that atom is neutral. As many number of protons present in the nucleus, the same number of electrons are out of the nucleus. That means in its orbits it revolves. So, when we say the atomic number, it denotes Z letter and also it says the number of electrons also. It is equal to number of electrons which revolves around the nucleus. So, what you should know? Atomic number is number of protons of an atom. This atomic number is denoted with the letter Z. And next one is mass number. What is mass number of an atom? Mass number of an atom together, that means number of protons in the nucleus plus number of neutrons. Mass number is number of protons plus number of neutrons which are present in the nucleus. And number of protons plus number of neutron will be denoted with the letter capital letter A. So mass number, number of protons plus number of neutron. Atomic number, only the number of proton which is present in the nucleus, and we know that as any atom is neutral, the same number, this is positive charge and electrons negatively charged will be equally of that number. And now, if you take any element, for example, an element X will take. An example, one element X. The symbol of an element we have taken as X. On the left side, upper part, we always write the mass number. For example, we take 23 and here 11. And this 11, okay, here we will write the atomic number Z and the mass number A. Will be denoted, any atom it is. Now if you take sodium as a symbol Na, atomic number 11 and mass number 23. So each element, its atomic number and mass number will be written the left side, upper and lower part. And upper part, it represents the mass number. Lower part, it represents the atomic number. So when, for example, chlorine you take. Chlorine, the atomic number will be 17 and its mass number is 35. Like that. And if you take carbon, atomic number is 6, mass number is 12. So this is the symbol of the atom, and this is the atomic number of the atom, and this is the mass number of the atom. So you can denote atomic with the symbol and atomic number and mass number. So you have to by heart the atomic number and mass number of each element. And by knowing this, by knowing the atomic number and mass number and the symbol, we can make the configuration of the element and its distribution of the electron in the element, any particular atom of an element. That part we will learn in the next class. So you should know from this part, the symbol Z denotes what, and the symbol A denotes what, and where, what is in the upper left side of the upper part of the symbol, what it denotes, and the lower part of the symbol, what it denotes. This you should know. One should read, know how to read this. When I write Cl 35 and 17, you should know how to read it. This is the symbol of the element chlorine. So chlorine has 17 atomic number and 35 mass number. So you should know how to read it. So here we'll stop it, and in the next class we learn how to distribute the electron in the electronic configuration of each atom.